I'm just gonna tweet about this impromptu stream very briefly. We're not gonna be doing any video games tonight. This is going to be an art stream. I think I'm going to try to do at least four pictures tonight. They're going to be kind of small. Some of them are going to be fully rendered, and some of them are not. All right. So, do let me know in the chat if you have any difficulty hearing me, and if can't see what I'm doing with the stream, with the art. I haven't done anything yet, so you should just see a white square at the moment. I'll let you know when. Just taking care of this little something here. Okay. Okay, so now we should be ready to begin. And just like last time, we're going to start with an off-white background. It's going to be pink. And today, we're going to do a little something with we're going to try to paint a flower, I believe. So I'm just gonna kind of sketch out to begin with the rough outlines of what I'm gonna do. So we're gonna do sort of a rose. It's not going to be perfect. So I'm just gonna draw in the petals. This is going to be sort of an abstracted rose. So we start with a little spiral here, and then we just draw petals. I like to go in threes. I know roses have a slightly different symmetry, I think. I don't think it's threefold, but I could be misremembering. Could be misremembering. So now we're going to draw some ragged outer petals. Just looping around, bringing them back in. Draw like where they're sort of turning over, so that you see. And I'll layer these ones in a little bit behind. As you see, I'm not like connecting them, these ones directly to the stem, because this is they're going to be mostly in shadow, and I'm just drawing the outlines of the parts that are going to be in light. Now, what I should have done here is draw this on an upper layer, but that's all right. That's all right. So now, what I'm going to do actually is redraw this. Above it. I'm just going to make this a little bit transparent. I'm added a new layer in Photoshop. I'm going to draw over the outline with a smaller brush, just so I can have a guide when I'm painting. And okay. Now that I have that those outlines, I can go back to my original layer. Save. And I'm going to drop my brush history tool on this step, so that way I can if necessary, I can return to that. Hello, Cassandra. Thanks for joining the chat. I didn't see you until just now. Photoshop sort of taking up most of my window. But hi, hello. How are you doing? I hope you like what we're doing today. I'm gonna start painting this. And to do that, I'm going to pick a sort of yellow-green color. And I'm going to do sort of a suggestion of a sort of bush or such in the background. What I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this layer and close it. Lock that layer again. Alright. Still thinking about Sharky Friend. So Cassandra's been watching Abzu, which is a game that just came out. I know nothing about that game. I just happened to see someone else streaming it. I popped in for a few minutes. It looks really pretty. I don't know anything about it. I don't know anything about Abzu, except that apparently it's got a shark in it, and he is very cute. Right, so I'm just kind of. It's one of the designers of Journey. Okay, all right. That explains a lot. It did kind of have that vibe when I was looking at it. It definitely had that sort of vibe to me. Oh gosh, excuse me, please, goodness. What I'm doing here is I'm just kind of, we're just letting these brush strokes show through, kind of doing suggestion of the plant behind the flower here. It's going to be as if this is out of focus is what I'm going to do here. It's underwater journey with a shark buddy. Oh my gosh. All right, I have to get this game. I have to get this game eventually. That sounds really, really fun. That sounds really, really great. I'm coming back in with the same color that I used for my outlines here, and I'm sort of darkening the edges and coloring back over the green just a little bit, sort of muting it somewhat, pushing everything a little bit more in that pink direction. Come back in and do this rose color here. It's $15 on Steam. It's not exactly the same as Journey, but I think, but it's really moody and lovely. That sounds great. That sounds really nice. I'll have to play that at some point. Because I'm definitely very into I loved Journey, and I'm really into those sorts of games. So what I'm doing here is I'm taking the blur tool, and I've used a brush with the blur tool. The blur tool is using a brush preset, so it's got a little bit of bristles or whatever that are pushing it around, but you can do this with just the regular blur tool as well. I'm just kind of like making this background a bit more indistinct, Shifting things around, bringing this dark stuff in a little bit closer. Moving some of these light bits out to make it look a bit more like leaves and the like. You like all the swimming and all the fish. You get to see it. You get to see a lot of different fish and stuff. I'm going to hang on to them and swim around with them. Oh my gosh! That sounds so cool. I'm going to have to look into getting this game because I'd really like to do that. I want to start a segment on my regular stream when I can get back to regular streaming. I'd like to start a segment just called Let's Wander. Where I play games like Journey or Abzu or other such things, and we just kind of wander around, see what we can see. All right, what I'm doing here is I'm just kind of smudging these petals a little bit. I'm just making them look a little bit more like paint strokes, as it were, smoothing out some of the details. So I've got my a little bit more of a sense of directionality. Because I've got my outline on another layer. I'm going to bring that in a little bit. Subnautica. Yeah, I really want to get Subnautica. I did not buy it during the summer sale because I ran out of money, but I really want to get it. And that would be an ideal sort of Let's Wander thing. I have the longest journey. I know not everybody is into that, but that's also kind of in keeping with the theme. Like, just sort of something to wander around in, see what we can see what we can do, meet some cool fishies, wildlife, etc. There's a game called Adrift, but I might have to put some warnings on that because I hear it's going to be very vertiginous. It's a game where you are on a space station and you're stranded, but you get to like kind of wander around and do some zero gravity stuff, and that looks kind of fun too. All right. I'm gonna do a little bit more of working around these, make them look a little bit more like petals than just distinct strokes. And we still want them to be indistinct. We just want to give a bit more of a sense of directionality with them. Yeah, I really want to get into playing some of those kinds of games on stream, because I think that would be fun and entertaining, and it'd be pretty low-key, so chat interaction could be nice. I'd have to get a second monitor to have chat up on, but that's doable. Bring this dark shape in somewhat, a little bit closer to these petals. Okay, I think that's looking good so far for a start. Try and get rid of some of this white stuff down here. And what I was thinking is we could make this rose a bit more violet or even blue-ish. Bring in a little bit more of definition. So this is the outline that we started with. If I take off that layer, I put on this and I drop the opacity. Oh, nope. Wrong layer. I drop this opacity down. Let's just make sure that's showing up on stream well. Okay, that is showing up. Drop that opacity down. I'm going to change the layer blending mode to multiply. And I'm going to bring that back up a little bit. That looks good. I like that. Underneath that layer and sort of on top of the first layer of paint, I'm going to make a new layer. And I'm going to grab sort of a bluish, light blue color. I use this color for like drawing clouds and things. I'm going to make my brush somewhat smaller. I'm going to start bringing that into these petals and such. I'm actually gonna do. Excuse me, goodness gracious. Of just painting over the pink parts with this bluish color. Just to kind of see, I'm doing this on a separate layer so I can just kind of get rid of it and see how it looks. If I like it or if I don't like it. What I might even do is do it like so, change the blending mode slightly and allow it to kind of sit on top. So transparent, and I'm actually going to choose an even lighter violet-ish color. Scrub that into these shadows here. I don't like that so much. Choose. Okay, there we go. I guess we're going baby blue here. Which is not what I was thinking originally, but seems to be working out okay. Yeah, blue. We're just kind of doing something a little bit different, a rose of a different color here. Just to kind of see. Got a bit of a robin's egg blue thing going on here. I'm actually going to grab this color and see if I can bring that in to some of these other areas. Some of the shadows and whatnot. Maybe. I think that was kind of when I decided when I saw you tweet that you were gonna paint your nails that color. There we go. I'm gonna so do the top edges of everything are going to be lighter, so that they sort of peel away from the center, and seems like it's lit from above. So down here it'll be the bottom edges of things because they're shaded from the top and don't get a chance to sort of glow until the light hits them toward the bottom. But then they peel away from that even as they continue on towards the bottom, so it's I'm going to make these shadows a bit more purple as they get toward the center. So, especially down here. As they come in. So, defining sort of the edges, it'll be darker by the outer edges of the layer of leaves that's closer. And then sort of going out toward the light again. It'll help to place everything forward a bit. Bring that out a little bit more. Bring that down a little bit more. Let's see. And darken some of these tips a little bit. What do we think? Is this looking a bit more full? We're gonna bring some of these in to sort of define these outer edges a little bit more. There are dinosaur swordfishes, by the way, in Abzu. That sounds rad. I want a dinosaur fish. Oh, excuse me, goodness gracious. I hope that wasn't too loud for you guys, chat. I've had bad hiccups today. Kind of like how this is turning out. I like how this is turning out so far. Make that even a little bit more opaque. And you can see how this layer here with the pink really affects the layers beneath. So without that outline layer, it just kind of looks like this muddy little mess. But if we drop that back in with the multiply, it brings everything together. It defines the edges of the petals a little bit more. I'm gonna pull it back just a tad to about 75% opacity, 80% opacity, somewhere in there. Save that. Dinosaur fishies. So cool. That is so rad. All right. I think we're gonna try to try to come up above the outline layer now. And we're gonna grab sort of that purple color. We're gonna this whole layer is gonna be 50% opacity. We're just gonna kind of scrub along these highlights, make them kind of glow a bit. No, actually, we're not. I don't like how that looks. I don't like how that looks. You like the mess, to be honest? It looks like a cloud. Yeah, it is. It does look kind of cool. It does look like a cloud. I want just a little bit more of this definition from the outlines. But I think what we might even be able to do. What if I move that above? But I can make a copy, move that above the outline, and make that less, maybe? No. Get rid of that. I throw my other outline on top. Oh, I don't like that. I don't like that. But I think this is looking pretty good so far. And copy that one more time. Looks nice and soft, like it would feel nice. Yeah, like if I can sort of feel this like brushing against my skin almost. It feels nice. All right. I'm going to come back in with my blur tool. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to move the outline layer. I made a copy of it so I don't lose the original outlines. But I'm going to sort of smudge these around to make them a little bit less conspicuous, a little bit less harsh. And I'm basically coming in and I'm emulating sort of like if I were taking my tool and I were tracing the flower petals, if you can imagine that, sort of like following them as they bend outward and inward. and this is going to soften them somewhat, but it's also going to compress them in other areas to make them like a little bit of a smaller line. It's kind of cheating, because normally what I would do is like come in and do a get rid of my outline layer and do another outline layer that was with a thinner brush. But I actually don't want to do that. Let's go back here a little ways. Okay. Gonna smudge this out a little bit, smudge this back in a little bit. Out in gives us a sort of jagged edge, inflates the edge of these petals a little bit, makes it a little more ragged looking, which I like. I'm going to smudge these inwards so they look more like a shadow, as you can see. I'm smudging these around. I'm just making the lines. With my smudge tool, I'm making the lines thinner in some places and thicker in others. And I'm taking the ones that are sort of like wrapped over an edge, as it were. You know, that would kind of come in and form a shadow. I'm making those blurred out somewhat. Smudge those a little bit. Especially over here where they kind of blend into the shadow beneath them. I'm just doing that same thing. I'm kind of smudging this outline to make it part of the shadow. Bring these down. And that preserves some of my line work originally, but it also kind of makes it a little bit look a little bit more like the brush strokes. Smudge petals like that when you draw roses. Yeah, it's a very similar process. And I'm actually kind of borrowing a lot of tricks that I figured out from watching you draw roses or talking to you about drawing roses. I never really used to draw flowers. But then once I sort of saw how you did yours, I started practicing and drawing a little bit more often, and it's really cool. I like it. I like it. I'll happily steal it. think we might be getting close to done with this. What do you think? What do you think? I'll come back down here maybe with my brush and kind of add back in some of the details that we lost when I smudged the some of these away. I've come back to the layer with my blue to do this. Yeah, I think we might be almost done with this one. Kind of feeling it, kind of feeling that way to me. We're gonna come back with the We're drawing in some of the darker background shades here, sort of show that the flower is casting something of a shadow on its surroundings. Erase some of what I've done on the outside here to bring it back to what I had before because I liked it. But we're too much there. I think I quite like this as it is so far. We'll back off some of that. Put it in. Oh yeah, that looks good. That looks good to me. What I might do is take my eraser and kind of knock out this layer that's kind of bringing the darker colors in. I don't like that. I don't like that. We're gonna go back up. We're gonna save. And I think what I'm gonna do is we're gonna come up here and I'm going to make my signature right about this area. 2016, because that is the year. If you're watching this from the far future, sorry. Don't you feel away? Maybe I feel old by the time you're watching this on YouTube in the year 2020 or beyond. Browsing back through someone's YouTube archive, if YouTube even still exists at that time, looking at videos at 3:45 in the morning. Yes, I see you back here from the past. Ha ha! And of course, if no one watches this at 4 in the morning, then I'm going to feel very silly. But I think I'm satisfied. I think I'm satisfied with how this looks. Yeah, pretty satisfied with this one painting. So we're going to save that. We're going to move on to our next painting, and I'm going to reset this. I'm going to save as Stream 01. So next painting, I'm not sure what I want to do here. I think we're going to start with a sketch. And Hooker Meow is in chat. She's Cassandra. She's got a Pokemon trainer. Maybe I'll paint that. Or let's go simpler. I'm going to do an Arcanine, which means I need to pop over to Google and take a quick look at what an Arcanine looks like. Okay. It's a big fluffy doggy with tiger stripes. Oh goodness, I was supposed to have three of these done tonight, and it's rapidly approaching at time, and I have an early morning tomorrow. I'm going to see what I can knock out in the next hour here. Let's tackle this. All right, so our next drawing. I'm going to come in here and we're going to start sketching in sort of the rough outlines of what we're working on. We're going to start with sort of some basic shapes. I know it's a doggy. There's going to be lots of sort of trapezoids here, sort of forming. And there's going to be sort of the rib cage here. And we've got our hips here and our big, goofy tail, I think. Yeah, he's got a fluffy tail. Alright, it's got a big fluffy tail, so it's going to be kind of here, and I guess it sort of jaggies out like so. Okay. I am not used to drawing Pokemon, so this is not going to be this is not going to be exact on model or anything, but I'm gonna do my best. I'm gonna do my best. I'd like to try. Let's see, where are the other regions of Floof? So he's got kind of Floof here-ish, and he's got Floof on his little ankles and heels. And of course, he's got big Floofies all in his face. All right, so I'm gonna knock this opacity down. I'm gonna move this guy a bit more like so. Center that. I'm gonna make my brush smaller now. And we're gonna start with the face. Let's see. And so around our eyes here, we've got this, and that area connects with our ears. I'm gonna put in this nose here. This cute little nose. And I'm gonna draw his eyes in. All right. That's looking good so far, I think. All right. He's got a little shoulder fluff that needs to come in a little bit from there. Do, 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 do. Oh, I haven't had chat up. What do you think so far? Think it's looking good? Weirdly, Pokemon is one of the first sort of anime-ish things. Thank you. I was hoping to make it cute for you. Pokemon is actually one of the first sort of anime-type things I ever drew. I think I started with like Pikachu and Mewtwo, of course, 'cause those were the big guys when I was first introduced to the fandom. My friend Seth actually introduced me to the game when I was riding the bus, I believe, over to his house one evening. I was in like fifth grade. And he had Pokemon Red, and some of our mutual friends had like Pokemon Blue and stuff. And I thought it was so cool. I had seen bits of the show and was kind of interested in it, and got into it sort of that way. So what I'm doing here is I'm making kind of these. I've made like thin outlines, and I'm coming back over with a thicker brush to sort of give it a bit more definition in some of these, and sort of thicken it in a few places, especially like as we kind of go toward the back here. Bit here to indicate sort of where it curves into the background. Yeah, they are kind of designed to be easy for kids to draw, and that's part of the appeal, right? That's sort of, you start drawing them and you share them with your friends. And it's Pokemon is one of those games that's like, I'm sure people shit on it for this, but I really like that. That like it's really, really easy for kids to get into, because I feel like part of the appeal of Pokemon is, you know, that it's a very low barrier to entry. Like, you don't have to get into the trading card game. You don't have to like buy, I mean, you probably are going to want to buy the games or whatever, but like, even if you don't or can't yet, you can still get into it. You can still get into the games and still get into the creatures and the TV show and whatnot. Or you can get like the little keychains and the plushies and whatever. And it's all kind of good. It's all kind of it's all part of being a fan. And I feel like it being a fairly easy fandom to get into is really a huge part of its charm for me. Because it just... Alright, and I've knocked out some of these thicker lines and whatever with my eraser to just kind of make it look a bit fuzzy and fluffy in those spots. And now comes the fun part. Now we get to color. What I'm going to try to do is sort of move this down and see if I can grab color from outside the program. I cannot. Darn. All right. Pupper. Oh, hello, Arcade Royal and Realtex. Yes, it is an Arcanine. I'm drawing that for Cassandra, who is in chat. Grimmel. Everybody say hi. Glad y'all can join us. Probably gonna stay on till like 11:30 or so, see what I can knock out. Trying to get three, maybe four drawings in tonight. We've got one so far. I'm gonna try to do this guy here. First thing I'm gonna do right now, I've got a reference photo of an Arcanine pulled up. And I'm going to drop it onto my desktop and then pull it into Photoshop. And oh my goodness, it is tiny. Goodness gracious. Right, well, let's scale that up. That's my reference drawing. So we're going to try and pull the colors from this before I delete it. Yes, we'll place that file. Good choice. Well, thank you. I saw... She's playing Pokemon Go, and I haven't gotten to play yet, but one of her guys is a Growlithe, who became an Arcanine very recently, and he's adorable, and I remembered how good Arcanine is, and I was just like, I want to draw that. I'm going to draw that. So that's what we're doing. He's a good boy. He's a very good boy. He's the goodest boy. He's the bestest. Alright. Let me just double check what I'm doing here. Right. You caught an Arcanine at District Taco? Nice. What did you name him? You've been naming your Pokemon. You've been naming your Pokemon like after where you named him Taco Puck Pup. Oh my gosh. That's adorable. Yeah, Eevees are the cutest. I might do an evolution next. I might do an evolution next. Maybe Sylveon or Umbreon, because those are some of my favorites. But first thing we're going to do is we're going to sample some of these colors to get them onto our oh gosh, excuse me, drawing as a for that I'm going to put my opacity back up to 100%. All right, so that's one color. This is a trick I learned from watching other people do draw in Photoshop. You add a layer just for your palettes and stuff. Oh, you didn't evolve your Arcanine. You caught him. That's awesome. That's even cooler. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. How cool is that? That's great. All right, we're gonna pull in. So I like to when I've got to refer back to colors a lot in a drawing, I sort of just make a new layer. I just put some swatches of them in at 100% opacity. There we go. Actually, those are probably only two I need for that one. And we're gonna grab this guy for the stripies. And I'm gonna grab this guy for the fuzzies, the fur, and a little bit brighter here. And I think the dark part of the fur is just this color layered over the orange, so I'm not actually going to grab that. So now we make our Growlithe reference disappear. Yes, your Charmander is named Iroh. That's great. He's the best fire uncle. He's the best. All right. So what I'm going to do is make a new layer. I'm going to put that underneath my line art layer. And that's where I'm going to color. So we're going to grab this orange. And we're going to start layering that in. In through here. The great thing about Pokemon is you don't really have to like fully render them. You can kind of cheat and just do flat colors. Well, that's not even cheating, it's a stylistic choice. And since I'm going to come back in with the fuzzy color, I'm going to color outside the lines just a little bit here to make sure that I've got full coverage. Full coverage. Do 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 do. And do. Infinite in an ex-Zuko, nice. You caught a Bellsprout! Yay! I love how you can kind of stay in place in some places and the GPS will just kind of jitter around enough to catch stuff. That is great. But yay, Bellsprout. I like Bellsprout too. Is Bellsprout the one that's like Upside Down, or is that the one it evolves into? It's been so long. It's been so long since I've really played Pokemon. All right. Okay. All right. I think I know what I'm gonna do here. We're going to snag this guy and move him over so I can take a look at where his fuzzy McFuzzes are. All right, we're gonna grab. They literally just spawn in your bed. That's great. Weren't you like overrun with Zubats for a while? Pull in little rump stripes here. I'm holding my tablet so that the brush comes in like edge end on to try and get these stripies, which look a bit more like fur. Thinking of Victory Bell as the one that's upside down. It is a terrifying thing. It's got like vampire fangs and stuff. It's like, when did this plant become goth? Like, when did this plant start listening to oh God, Bauhaus? Just the Victory Bell rocking out in an attic somewhere to Bela Lugosi's Dead. Pull that in here. Dum-dum-dum-dum-dum-dum. Did you see all your Golbats? I did see there were a lot of Golbats. I did see that you had a lot of them. By the way, for those in chat, because I've been just been kind of ignoring this, I am using Photoshop CS6 to draw with here. Eventually I am going to move to Krita, which is a free drawing program, which has a lot of painting tools and such. It's supposed to rival Photoshop, actually, for this kind of work, and it's free. So whereas Photoshop CS6 is right now it's running me about $11 a month to keep the subscription. So I will be switching to that eventually, but for tonight this is what I'm using. But the techniques and stuff like that are pretty much universal. Like there's pretty much every drawing program is going to have layers and brushes and things of that nature. So this is if you're watching to learn, the stuff you're seeing here will transfer pretty easily. All right, we're going to get rid of the overlay a little bit. I realized that my guy should have fuzzies all the way around his little feet here. Darn. I did not properly pay attention to my reference material. That's all right. We can just draw those in a little bit later. come up here and knock out the this part. On that level. Okay. Now we're going to come in and draw the shadows on the stripies. Going to let the shadows of the stripes sort of indicate how things are curving here. I'm going to let there be a highlight in this area and here because these are sort of the highest points of these curves. I'm going to let there be a little bit of a highlight in front on the paws as well. Oh, I am using an old Intuos 3 12x12 tablet, which is I've had since 2007, and it has served me very well. It is my baby, but it is on its last legs, and I really, really, really would like to replace it with a You got another horsey! That's awesome! More like Poison Ivy got to the victory bell. Yeah, that's true. Real Flex, you named your Arcanine Woof Bark Arf. It's very silly. But yes, as for the tablet, it's an Intuos 3. I would like to very much to replace it with an Intuos 4. Not the Intuos 5, which is wireless and like a pound heavier than the Intuos 4, but I want to replace it with an Intuos 5, like, I think 12x10 tablet. It's on my wish list, actually. I don't have a Cintiq donation bar, but I do have a tip jar, and I have an Amazon wish list under the stream, if anybody feels like contributing. I can find the Intuos 4s used for like almost like $200. It's supposed to be $200 new, but they don't make them anymore, which is sad. I kind of missed my chance. But you know, we're trying. I don't want to worry about a Cintiq at the moment because they're way too expensive. And I'm in the process of like getting an apartment and stuff, so. Yeah, but an Intuos 4, the one I was looking at, is going to give me almost the same drawing area that I actually use on this gigantic thing, but it's going to be a lot more portable, which is great. Anyway, that's enough rambling from me about about tablets and such. I'm going to pop in some highlights in the fuzzies. What was that? I just got a boing notification. I guess someone must have tagged me in something. We're gonna pop in a highlight at the top of the ears, up here on the top of the rump, and a little bit here, kind of around. And on the top of the footies, do 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 do, yoink. Let's see. Better come back in here and draw in the dark strip again, because I kind of messed that up. Oh well. This is fine. Everything's fine. Now we're going to draw in the fuzzies. This will be lots of fun. I'm just gonna push that in there. Look at the happy doggy. He's such a good dog. Alright. I'm just gonna go whoop 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 whoop. Yip doop 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 doop. And you see how, like, since I went over the lines earlier, when I'm coming back in with the fur, it kind of blends over as my opacity changes. And looks a bit more like fur there without much effort. But yeah, the fur on Arcanine looks a lot like, you know, sort of sooty clouds, which I love. I love that. But yeah, one of the little tips and tricks I have is, like, when you're drawing in sort of fuzz and things that floof, you can kind of make little swooping strokes to kind of indicate the direction that these things are flowing. It works for clouds, it works for fur, fire, liquids, fluids, things like that. And you may not think that if you're, like, covering it thoroughly that would make much of a difference, but it really does help your lines and such, and where you overlap as well will look. You'll have very subtle variations in opacity and thickness and stuff. And those will be picked up by the brains of the people looking at your art. Even if it's really hard to point out what is happening, it'll make a difference. Which is really cool, I think. Alright, we're gonna come in with our darker color now. And we're gonna use very, very light strokes to get this. And again, we're just sort of like paying attention to the sort of masses of the fur here, and we're going to use those same like swooping strokes to fill it in. Bring it up like so. I'm going to put a little shadow here under the chin to indicate where some of these would be. Same way here, we're going to come in to indicate where this kind of moves into the background here, and where there's a shadow underneath. Over here. Very good, very good. We're going to keep our highlights up here because the light source is coming down this way. I'm actually going to do is I'm going to come back in and show a little bit of a shadow under here, so it looks like it's coming out to the front and moving back. Now that I've filled that in a little bit, I see a mistake. Wah, my bad, Realflex says. I don't know what happened, Realflex, but I'm sure it's fine. I don't think anything bad happened. I'm pretty sure it's fine. But whatever it is, you're forgiven. I promise you. All right. Shadow a little bit here. And a little bit of a shadow in the front of the Nos. Grab this mid-tone here and kind of pull that in here-ish. And bring that back in a little bit here. And now that I've drawn in the sort of colors and masses of things with the fluff, I'm actually going to come back up to my line art layer, and I'm going to knock out some of this in here and let the shadows and stuff speak for itself as to sort of communicate where things are going and so on. And that's another little tip that sort of helps things look a little bit naturalistic, I guess. Knocking out some of your line art later as you sort of get more detail in with your colors and such. Letting that kind of do its thing. Back down to the line art layer, I'm going to fill in with the fur color and then the fluff color a bit more. Okay, this is looking really good so far, guys. I kind of like where this is going so far. And we'll come back in with that. A little bit more of the bright colors here. Give more bright colors. Okay. Now I'm going to come back up to my line art. I'm going to grab my line color, and I'm going to fill in a little bit of definition back into. This is kind of, my drawing style is a little bit rough. That's because I, when I do it very quickly, that feels more natural to me, but also like what I do is I come back in. It's a lot of going back and forth, filling in some one thing until you get a bit more of an idea where that's going, and then coming back and adjusting. It's really cool. All right. I'm actually gonna get rid of that now. I think we're nearly there, folks. We're gonna pull in a little bit of this fluff there, and a little bit there, and just a tiny bit here on the edge. How long have I been drawing in general, not this stream, Realflex? Do I need glasses? Realtex, sorry. I have been drawing since I was like 5. I've been drawing seriously, and by that I mean like with paying attention to like improving my technique. Probably since 10th grade, I suppose. So that's, I'm 27 now. That is too many years. Too many years to think about. That's how long I've been drawing. I have been drawing long enough to make myself feel incredibly old. Which I'm not. I'm not actually that old. 27 is still very young. I just realized that like I actually don't have a good idea about how long I've been doing this. All right, so just filling in a little bit more here with the edges. But yeah, like it's sort of a interesting thing when people ask that because I don't feel like that has very much bearing on my actual ability to draw. I feel like not only is it sort of thing where like drawing is more about practice, but also like there are people who are like way younger than I am who are way more accomplished. And there are people who are a lot older than I am who are just getting started. And it really sort of depends on you know, it depends on the person. It depends on a lot of factors and like and so on. I think I'm quite happy with the fluff here. He looks very regal. What a good boy. What a good boy. What a very good boy. And we'll knock out some of that there. What I'm actually going to do is I'm going to come back to my background. And I'm going to fill it in with a pink color. I come up to this we're going to go sort of off-white. Off-white behind the eyes. And I'm gonna come back up to my line art layer, and I'm just going to make a little bit of a black line here for the shadows. I'm going to zoom in and we're going to come back in with the light color. All right. What a good boy. What a good pup. We'll draw a little bit of a highlight on the nose here. And now I will save this file. Save. Yes. Oh right, I've got to put in a little bit of a shadow here on the bottom. So that's what I'm going to do here. Right underneath this guy. Righty. Alrighty. All right, kind of a cop out of a shadow here, but we're gonna just blend that out a little bit. And take my smudge tool, 'cause I love my smudge tool. And there we go. There we go. There we go. Perfect. All right. So yeah, I do a lot of this kind of by feel and intuition. Which, if I were being a little bit more deliberate, I could probably talk through like why I'm putting things here and there. I'm just sort of like feeling out, okay, this is sort of the general shape of the shadow, and I'm smudging it around to be a little bit closer to what I think it would look like. But that, I think, is good for our Arcanine. We're going to save. Actually, first I'm going to put my signature on right here. And we're going to save. Always remember to save your documents, kids. I'm going to delete my palette layer. I'm going to flatten this. I'm saving it as, in this case, I'm going to save it as a PNG because I'm sending it to someone. And I also just like PNG as a file type. That moment where you gotta stop drawing because you lost your sharpener. Oh man, I hate that. That's why I switched to mechanical pencils when I was in high school. I love. There's a particular brand of mechanical pencil, and I can never remember the brand name off the top of my head. But they're like tapered toward the end, and they're nice and heavy at the back. They feel really good in my hands, and I always lose them, and I always have to buy more. I think they're Staedtler or something, but yeah, 5 millimeter mechanical pencils. It's what I use in all my notebooks and things. But if I'm drawing on a, like if I'm doing charcoal drawings and stuff of something I want to smudge around, I use sometimes I'll use actual charcoal pencils, but something else that I found works really, really well. You can actually get like little twigs of willow that have been burnt until they are completely charcoal, and you can draw with those. It feels a little weird at first, but they're self-sharpening, and you get like a really interesting texture off of that. and your drawing surface. So I highly recommend checking out Willow Twigs for drawing. All right, well, this Arcanine is done, so that is drawing number 2 of the stream. We got 2 more. I think we can knock that out. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to go to my history. I'm going to pull back to the original, and I'm going to save as PSD, and I'm going to call this stream 02. I index from 0 because I have a lot of programming friends, but that's just kind of my own personal quirk. What do we think? I think we're gonna go. We're gonna do another Pokemon. I think we're going to do Sylveon this time. So I'm going to go to Le Google and Sylveon. Oh, I forgot Sylveon has a little bow on its head. Okay. I'm going to view that and pull it out here. Actually, that's kind of large enough to be a good reference thing. We're going to make that invisible for now. And we start here again with a layer for the sketch. I'm going to knock my brush back to about 50% opacity, and I'm going to make it nice and big. And while I'm zoomed out here, I'm going to just start roughing in. So what does it look like? I'm going to start roughing in the shapes here. So it's Hello, Arcade Royal. Welcome back. We just finished Arcanine. We just finished our Arcanine. And yes, we are doing Magical Girl Eevee, the best Eevee. My favorite might actually be Umbreon, but Sylveon is like right there. I just got pinged again. Hold on, I'm going to see what's going on with this. Yes, we're drawing another Pokemon. Let's see. Everybody is around. Okay, cool. We got everybody back in chat now. So, right. So we're going to do Magical Girl Espeon, and that gives me an idea. That gives me an idea. Why do you give me ideas? Oh no, this is becoming more complicated than I was originally planning. But I think that'll be fine. So, Sylveon has kind of a trapezoid head, right? And we've got sort of we're going to kind of do a thing here. Gonna have paws coming down like so. And a little paws coming down this way, and then we have a paw coming down. Here. kind of, this is becoming, this is looking a little bit more like a Greyhound, but I suppose that's all right for Sylveon. Sylveon has a short, fluffy tail. So I'll rough that in here. But then we've got big fluffy ears and a ribbon. Two ribbons. We've got a ribbon here. And a ribbon up here. I have the ears kind of coming back like so, and then I have the eyes closed and little nose like so. I think what I'm going to do here is I'm going to have, because this is the magical girl, they wrap their ribbon excuse me. Around their trainer's arm. That's so adorable. Oh my gosh. What I might do here is I might make the ribbon even more like flowy and ridiculous. Because I want to get the magical girl vibe going really strong here. I think I can do that with and going to have Saturn down here some way. Because Sailor Saturn is also one of the best Sailor Scouts. Kind of want to have her. Should I have this Sylveon jumping onto Saturn? I think so. I think that's what I want to do. Okay. Maybe. I don't know. Maybe I'm being a little bit too ambitious here. I'm not sure if I dig it. I mean, I dig it, but I'm not sure if I got it in the right place. What do we think, chat? Do we want Saturn here? Do we want a... We're going to move some of these. Because I'm still doing the sketches, I can kind of shift things around as I please, and it's not going to, like, matter too much. Okay. All right. Deselect. Clearly, like in September, I would have been drawing for a year. Can't do digital anymore, though, since my computer broke. Oh, that sucks, Realtex. Grimal left a link. I do not play Pokemon Go. I want to. Oh my gosh! That link that just got linked by Grimeow, is the most Sailor Moon Sylveon thing ever. That is so great. But yeah, I don't play Pokemon Go yet. I've got a new phone I'm gonna activate here at the end of the week, and then I'm gonna start playing. But there's just been a lot of stuff going on. Oh my gosh, Glowy Sylveon. Too cute. Too cute. Too cute. All right, we're gonna. Excuse me. All right, so we're going to. So we're gonna have the pause, the back pause, sort of like this, and we're gonna have the. Front paws together like so. Like she's kind of leaping down. And what we're going to do with the ribbons here, decided, is we're going to make them even more flowy and ridiculous. We're going to have them come forward, and then back, and around, like. We okay, and that should go that way actually. This one will be a little bit kind of long-ish. And right, so right now the sketch looks kind of like a mess, and that is fine. We are okay with this looking like a mess at the moment. Because this is just the rough sketch, and we're going to clean that up quite significantly. When we start to draw in the rest of our second sketch. So we're going to make this opacity really, really low. I'm hitting around 25-30%. We're going to add a new layer on top of that one. I'm going to take my I've lost the word, my brush a little bit smaller. Let me just check my facial features here. All right. So, and we'll give her the anime sort of bean face, bean-shaped face. Gotta have the bean-shaped face. What does the nose look like? Oh, it's tiny. It's just a tiny little dot nose. Tiny little dot nose. I don't like the mouth. I messed up the mouth. And blue hair for some reason. Gotta have the blue hair. We're reaching back there for those of us in our audience who may not be up on the Home Star 1 hour, which that was a time of history. was a All right. And she's got the little cute, like Ming the Merciless, but cute going on with the shape of the sort of heart-shaped thingy going on. Not a heart-shaped box, although it could be. It could be. We could be Courtney Love. I'm gonna give her eyelashes because why not? Why not? And the bow. Take me back to Geosities, where sights are bad and kinks are shitty. Gifts are shitty. Oh gosh. We are combining two old now dad humor. Like that is dad humor now. Twice over with the God, is it Guns N' Roses that's singing that song? Feel like it is, because I don't care for that song, and I don't really care for a lot of Guns N' Roses. I don't know where to draw the ribbon here. I'm probably going to draw the ribbons on a separate layer because I like this bow quite a lot, and I don't want to mess that up. Right, we got a little fuzz by the ears. Boop, boop, boop. The ears themselves have a little boop. Whoop. The very technical term, the whoop whoop. Similarly here, whoop whoop. It's a bit too jaggedy. Great thing about drawing on the computer is that you have an undo button, which you don't have when you're drawing on paper. So now we'll add a little Wink. No, my beautiful joke, don't ban me. I won't ban you. I'm not you. Let's see here. We're going to. Yep, do. And Little toe beans, because of course it's going to have toe beans. It's an Eevee, it's got to have some toe beans. Also, apparently is breaking its back. I am sorry. This is becoming an Escher Girls thing. Hiccup. Sorry, folks. My apologies. Alright, and there's our toe beans on the other foot. And this one. Toe beans! Best thing. Okay. That's not bad so far. Let's see how much further we can get here before midnight. This is when I turn into a pumpkin. Said I was going to come up to a different layer to do the ribbons, and I am doing that right now. So I made a new layer. Try and figure out where these suckers are going to go. Okay, so that's one ribbon side. This one is going to be okay. Come on. No. Okay, so there's a ribbon going off that way as well. Zoop. Zoop, zoop. Sorry if this is not entertaining for folks, this is kind of getting into the zone here, and it becomes difficult to talk at times about what I'm doing. How are we all doing tonight? What's shaking out there in the wide world? Got lots of ribbons floating all over the place here. The ribbons themselves are way off model. They're way longer than dropped my stylus here. Sorry, folks. Hand digital forms and organizers of makeup stuff. Nice! That's good to do, though. Getting makeup things organized. Speaking of makeup, for those in our audience who might be aspiring artists, and are sort of looking for something to watch besides Bob Ross, makeup tutorials on YouTube. Actually, really, really good. For learning sort of facial anatomy and things, because I was watching them on Cassandra's suggestion, actually, a while back, and the sort of highlighting and contouring and things like that they do there is very, 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 very similar to the sorts of stuff that you do when you are drawing faces and painting faces on people and things. So it's actually a really good resource if you're looking for something like that. All right, so now we're going to drop out our second layer here. All right, and now I think we're going to. Wayne Goss is good to watch. Yeah, he's very soft spoken as well. Got a nice voice to listen to. A lot of good tips and tricks and things. Did I get sunburned through my shirt today? Sorry, I was just scratching my back and like I'm like burning up back there. That is very odd. I did sunburn like one arm. Well, like a quarter of my arm, because I had it hanging out of the side of a truck. I was helping my parents move, and I didn't put any sunblock on because I haven't been going outside a lot lately. So I didn't think about it, and I am like one quarter lobster at the moment. I'm gonna run that under some cold water before I go to bed again. Yeah, good times. Good times. Alright. I do want Saturn in here, and what I'm going to do probably is draw Saturn in the background. Sort of like so. there. Alright. So, on to the colors here. So let's get our palette ready. And let's grab our pink. We'll grab our lighter pink. We'll grab our dark blue. Our light blue. And there's an intermediate blue, like right there. But I think we can also get that just from blending the light blue with the dark blue. That's kind of looks like what it's happening here. Surprisingly, not a lot of colors on Sylveon. I suppose if I had taken like 5 seconds to actually look at this Pokemon before, I would have noticed that, but I did not. I did not. So, we're gonna knock out our, we're gonna take off the layer with our ribbons for the moment, and we're just going to focus on drawing in our, or painting in our colors underneath our line art here. So we've got little pink paws, so we're gonna start with our pink color, base coat pink. And we're gonna go like so, and then and there's sort of a V shape at the top here. And let's grab our lighter pink to sort of indicate that this is the top nearest side of our draw back in our shadow on that side. And now we'll use our eraser to define that V shape I was talking about a little bit more. And we'll come back in like so, and like so. And erase. Zoop. There's no shame in using the eraser. Pixie Woo is really good too. This is why you push sunscreen. Yeah, you always recommend like the SPF 35 zinc powder stuff or whatever. And I just go outside and turn into a lobster every few months. But yes, listen to Grimmel. Use sunscreen. Use sunscreen liberally. And we'll come back in like so. Da, 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 da. Alright. What I'm actually going to do is come back up to our line art and knock out some of these lines. Like I mentioned before, a lot of my drawing process is just like, do a thing, do a little bit more of a thing, see if you like how the thing looks, come back in, do even more of a thing. It's a lot of back and forth kind of stuff. We're going to save. You recommend a physical sunscreen, yes. Yep. Which, I mean, frankly, it seems like a really good idea. And I wish, on today of all days, that I had paid attention and taken that advice to heart. I mean, I did pay attention, but it's, I mean that I did not follow through on actually using it. Blue Lizard. Is that the brand? All right, we're working on our ears here. And grab our light pink here, and we'll start sort of adding our highlights. Again, great thing about Pokemon is that because it's kind of an anime style, you really only need two colors, maybe three. You've got your mid-tone and your highlight, and sometimes you have a shadow as well. Sometimes. Okay, so Sylveon is looking like something between a rabbit and a greyhound right now. I'm not sure if I'm kind of getting this right, but it looks cute. She looks cute. I think it's working. Doesn't smell very strong. The smell looks kind of sick, so that's important to me. Oh, that's great, because I hate that sunscreen smell as well. That's so we've got an endorsement for Blue Lizard here in chat. Sunscreen. Very good. Very good. Alright, now we're gonna grab our lighter color. Come right in here. So I think what I'm going to end up doing with Sylveon is taking out some of our line art, because I think it's kind of distracting from the color. Oh yeah, yeah. If I just make that less opaque, that looks pretty good. Right. Now, oh, right. About to grab our shadow color here on our palette. So now we come in and grab our highlight again. Just highlight a little bit at the top of the head here. Okay. And ribbons are like so, with a little bit of a lighter color at top. Same thing here. Start like this. I've realized I've got sort of the shape of the ribbons wrong. I made them more complicated than they needed to be. But I don't really feel like going back through and changing them, so I hope that's okay. I hope that's all right. Kind of screwed up the shape of the ribbons. Oh well. That said, I'm going to knock out some of this here. I guess we can save that. I'll just And boink. Back up to the top. The ribbons move, so you can do a lot of stuff with them. Oh, well, that's fantastic then. The fact that I'm making them like super exceedingly long is not going to be a huge issue then. Ha ha! We're going to use the dark blue color for the eyes, because they are closed. So I'm going to pretend that those are her eyelids and lashes. Like that. And now, we're going to reintroduce our ribbons. But I'm going to turn the opacity down on these guys way, way, way a lot. So what I'm going to do is come in with our dark pink. We're going to start back like this color layer, that's where I want. I'm going to start that like here. Here-ish. Like here-ish. Oh, actually. We'll erase that here. Start that leg. Here-ish, I guess. And exercise in Pokemon horror interpretations. Do you think the ribbons are part of Pokemon? They are. Oh boy. They're just like tentacles. That's awesome. Yay for magical girl tentacle creatures. And not in a weird way, like in an actual like this is pretty rad kind of way. Okay, so now we start to do that, and that eventually fades out to that. And we'll kind of train that in with a bit of a erase tool here. Same thing with the next one. Grab our dark blue. Here we're actually going to start that a little bit earlier, like here-ish. And that will continue through there. Which we will cut off there. Start on a light blue there, and continue it through there until the end. And again, we will grab our erase tool, Use that to kind of constrain where these are. They divide, make that into like a dividing line with the next ribbon. And again here, dividing line with that ribbon. Alright, weird fact of the evening. I now, for no reason that I can discern, I have... Do y'all know, Mannheim Steamroller? They do the Christmas music that's, like, very synthy. They had a band before they were Mannheim Steamroller that did trucker songs. And there is a song called We've Got a Mighty Convoy, I think. Or maybe it's just Convoy. Anyway, that's stuck in my head now for no discernible reason, and I am not happy about it. So I figured I would have to share the pain with the rest of you. It's only right. It's only fair. Only fair. I should stab myself in the brain, to be honest. Yeah. Reach out and wrap them around your wrist when they walk next to you. They're like little feelers. Oh my gosh, that's so cute. Glaceon has similar things. They must be like really cold though. The ones that Glaceon has, I would imagine. It's got to be like really really chilly. Right, I'm gonna extend this pink part back a little ways. Right, so this ribbon here is coming behind this front ear, because I like the front ear, but it's going over the tail, I think, is how this is going. Yep. So I'll just come back up to my line art as well, and knock out that line. And that one too. Ta-da! I'm also going to knock out these lines as well, because we're going to imply that this ribbon is passing in front of them. And come back here. Yep. Oh, wrong layer. Gotta go back to my color layer. Important to keep your layers separate, kids. Yeah, good enough. Good enough. Grab our dark blue. We'll come in like so. Start that right about here. And keep that going right up and over the end. Grab our bright blue. And we'll bring that down like so. Up our lightish blue, and we'll color that in here. Bright blue again, and come back over And we'll come back in with our eraser tool and carve out the outline of this ribbon as it comes up and flies this way. I messed up the curve. As I was saying, we're going to take our eraser tool and carve out the what's it. And we're going to carve out this end as well. Bring that in nice and smooth. There we are. Look. Oh my gosh, you're right. Glaceon does have, like, the little... It makes her look like a very stately Japanese lady with the hair things. I don't remember what that style of hair is called, but it's very cool, and I like it. I like it. Right. So now, what I'm going to do is, on this same layer, we're going to start using this one color. We only have one color for shadows here. And I'm going to start using that to sort of shape the anatomy of our friend here. And we're going to come back and use our wonderful friend the smudge tool to kind of like push that back a little bit where we need to. Again, kind of just going by feel here. Come back to our brush tool. Grab this color and use that as a intermediary. And come back to the darker one and come back up through. Move that down here very, very, very lightly, very gently. Okay, this sort of rump area here. And in between the forelegs, a little bit on the bottom of this leg here. We're also going to use it to define shadows on our ribbons here. So this here would have a little bit of a shadow as it comes in, and this here would have a little bit of a shadow as it goes around. Comes out the other side, and a little bit of shadow here. And likewise here. But we're going to sharpen that a little bit, suggest going around the corner of the ribbon. Ribbon tentacle thingies, as we've determined. And a little bit from there, we're gonna sharpen those lines a little bit. Add a little bit of a outline there. We're also gonna bring that up somewhat brighter. Somewhat brighter. All right, now gonna and see. Look, without the outlines, without those outlines at least, our ribbon looks quite nice. So now what I'm going to do is come up to our regular outline layer. We're going to use our shadow color as opposed to our other color for light outlines, and we're going to lightly, with a very, very thin brush, we're going to outline the shape of our ribbons right up until they get to the colored areas. Once we get to the color, we don't have to worry about defining it the edge so much, because it won't be white on white, it will be colors on white, and we'll just let the let those speak for themselves. We're actually not going to outline where it intersects the color of the tail either, because that is a clear contrast between color and white. So really all I need to do here is just the barest suggestion of the edge going here, like so, kind of like here, and back around this way. And once it gets to the color, we don't worry about it anymore. And that should be pretty much that for Sylveon. I was going to put Saturn in the background, but I'm almost happier with it like so. Looks like a bit like a Hime cut, if that's what you mean. Yeah, I think that's what I mean. I'm not aware of all the terminology. So much. I've only gotten three done tonight. Oh, we've got to color the inside of the ears. I nearly forgot. Come back to our color layer. Just do the inside of the ears. All right, we're going to save this because I think it looks pretty darn good. Princess hair, like kind of like mine from Avatar. Yeah, it's that look. Yep. Which is a great haircut. I'm quite fond of it for people with like really straight hair. Or at least I'm fond of it as a character design thing. Yeah. All right. What do you think, chat? Should we put Saturn in the background, or should a painting of Saturn be our next painting tonight? So we want to do four. I think I can do Saturn pretty quickly and make it look nice. What do we think? What's our thinking here? I'm kind of thinking maybe. Yeah, I think I'm gonna leave Sylveon as she is. I'm gonna sign in blue here, I think. With a little blue heart. Because why not? We'll save again. Then we'll drop out our palette here. I did, but I was an idiot. Oh well. Let's see. Yeah, I think we're gonna call this good for Sylveon, and I will do a separate picture of Saturn. Is my current thinking on this front. So we will flatten this. And save it as a PNG file. And we'll pop this back to original, but we will save as ESD stream 0. Oops. 3. So we'll start off this time with filling in the background with black. We'll come back to our brush. Grab a nice. I don't know, I think it would look cute on your hair, sort of slightly wavy. Grimmel. All right. Saturn. I could look up a reference picture for Saturn. I don't think I want to. I think what I'm going to do is kind of wing it color-wise. I know that Saturn is sort of in the yellowish range of things. So we're going to start there, but we're going to bump it a little bit more yellow than that even. Think what I'm going to do is actually we're going to even make that a little bit less saturated. Less saturated even. Okay. I'm going to start with the rings. So come in like so. much thinner. You want these to get eventually much thinner on this side, so we'll make our brush a little smaller. Give the effect of the rings kind of around. And there's little gaps in the rings as well. I guess I should say that this isn't going to be exactly Saturn, because I don't have a reference picture of Saturn sitting in front of me. This is going to be Saturn-like, I suppose, would be a more proper term. I'm going to try and maintain our gaps from the other side as well. Not going to be exact. It's never going to be exact because we are freehanding this. Now we're going to draw the guest of honor itself here. We're actually going to grab our sky blue a little bit, sort of outline the edge of where we would like our Saturn to be. Because, interestingly enough, when Saturn is in shadow, in the shadow of its rings, it has a very blue atmosphere, just like Earth's. It's only when its clouds are in sunlight that they look sort of yellow-orange-ish. Get rid of that because I don't like it. Doesn't look right to me. Alright. Come back with our light blue. We're just going to hit very barest edges here. And right now I'm just kind of doing this to sort of get a feel for the roundness. I have a terrible time drawing circles, so I'm just kind of feeling my way around this here. Maybe a bit of backlight from the rings over that area-ish. Alright, good enough. Now we come back to our ring color. And we start filling in sort of close-ish here. First, we'll grab more of this blue as we come back around the side. More of this bright again. Especially over here. I'm going to make this a bit more saturated now. And a bit more red. That looks better. Much better, much better, much better. Grab our dark blue here, come back in like so. Again, this is all about like back and forth kind of stuff. And as the colors mix, I'm using the eyedropper tool to grab some of the mixed colors and throw those back in. On top of their more sort of pure colored neighbors. This is a pretty quick way of getting sort of blending without like using a smudge tool or anything like that, or gradients. I know that Saturn has some weird bandy things, so we're going to try and bring those in. We're going to vary the size of the brush, big and small. Grab our pure color again, move that around. Bright color again, move that around. Round and round and round. Okay. Now we've done that quite a lot. We'll fill in some of the gaps here. Alright, now take our smudge tool. We're going to start swirling some of this junk around. Saturn is a very turbulent planet with lots of weather systems and the like. So I'm using a very coarse brush with our smudge tool at first to kind of get some banding going on. We've got our smudge this out here to sort of smooth things over and make it a little bit more close to our bring the light from the sun around and make the atmosphere a little bit more indistinct as we come around the limb of Saturn. I have to correct that manually in a second, but for now, you can sort of pull stuff around. Don't be afraid to like swirl. Saturn does have storms; they're not quite as prominent as the ones on Jupiter, so feel free to kind of make swirls and things of that nature. We're not going for scientific accuracy here so much as impressionism, I suppose, would be the word. I'll bring some of this darker stuff up and the lighter stuff over. You gotta remember, Saturn has these little bands. They tend to, it's where the storms tend to cluster in little equatorial bands. They'll be rotating one way up here and then opposite down here. And then opposite again this way, and then this way. You see, as we keep working, working this over and over and over and over again, we start to get the smudges start to take on their own sort of characteristics. And that's what we really want here, that's what we're going for. I'm going to make our brush bigger here to kind of bring in the dark side stuff. Smooth that out a little bit more. Again, counterclockwise, then clockwise, then counterclockwise, then clockwise. Back and forth, up and down all around here. Come back in here and grab our ring color with our brush and just reestablish these rings here. And very, 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 very not quite happy. I'm gonna back off on that correction I did there, because I think I'm happier with it being a little distorted there. Grab a little bit of our shadow color here and drop our opacity to like 20%. And color over the cloud shapes that we've already made to try and suggest that this is sort of where nightfall and sunset are happening over here. Grab a black color, bring that over even more. We'll go back to our smudge tool and start smudging that again. Reestablish some of these storms and things. And clockwise, counterclockwise, etc.
That looks good.
I'm happy with that. We will control S to save. I'm actually going to grab these guys and bring them closer. Oop. Not quite what I wanted to do. Grab our brush tool. Very, very gently smooth some of this out. up over here. I'm quite happy with that. We'll save. Grab our red color here. And I'll drop my signature in here-ish. Right. Opacity 100. Go. Probably right about here. 2016. Control S. And I will save this as a PNG as well. And that's four. That's four drawings tonight. I'm very happy with this. Let me just make sure that I didn't lose our Nope, it's still there. I just didn't save that as a JPEG or a PNG yet. So, layer, flatten image, yes, file, save as PNG. Okay. So, there we have it. We've got four images done tonight. I'll probably separate these out when I make highlights. So it's not one giant 3-hour stream. Thank you very much, everybody, for coming out, who stayed to watch. Thank you, Riaflux, for joining us, and Grimmyow. Feel free to follow the channel here. I plan to come back to doing regular streams once sort of job situation and everything kind of settles in, but you can follow me here on this channel. I have links below the video in my info bars for my social media, my art page where you can commission me and look at my other art, and also my Twitter where you can follow me for updates and things like that as we go on. And of course, if you follow the stream, you'll get a notification when I go online. Thank you for watching. It was a lot of fun. I'll see you all later. Cheers, everyone. Yes, and thank you, Cassandra, for dropping the link there in chat. Thanks for coming out. Have a good night, everyone, and yes, good times. Good night.